Good morning, Lancaster Catholic.
I'm Natalie Knox.
And I'm Aria Young.
Today is Tuesday, January 14th, B-Day. Today's lunch is pancakes, sausage links, hash browns, and fruit.
This is the last morning show of the first semester, so we decided to do a special edition today. We'll take a look back and a look ahead into 2020.
2019 was hot, really hot. The summer was a scorcher in much of Europe, the U.S., and Australia, where it helped to fuel the current wildfires. Scientists say last year was the second warmest on record. Only 2016 was hotter, and not by much. Less than one-tenth of a degree Fahrenheit.
While global temperatures may be rising, population growth in our country is falling. In fact, the Census Bureau says it's the lowest since the 1930s. Families aren't having as many babies, people are living longer, and fewer immigrants are coming into this country.
On the bright side, our nation's economy is having its longest expansion ever. Why should you care? Well, if the nation's economy grows, that means your parents might be in better financial shape and there will be more jobs for us. In fact, the unemployment rate is the lowest it's been in 60 years.
And here's a switch in the job market. In 2019, women surpassed men as the majority of job holders in this country. And they represent a greater share of non-traditional jobs, like mining, logging, manufacturing, and transportation.
But the news was not good for the milk industry, which is huge here in Lancaster County. Jamie Ely says the situation is utterly dire.
Two major milk companies in America have had to move into bankruptcy. Dean Foods and Borden Dairy Company have had to declare Chapter 11. Why? It's because we aren't drinking enough milk. We have had a lot more variety of drinks like soda and flavored water. Also, other on-the-go breakfasts have replaced our morning bowl of cereal. More than 2,700 U.S. dairies have gone out of business over a span of 18 months. Since 1975, milk consumption in America has fallen by more than 40%. I'm Jamie Ely.
One artist dominated the recording industry going into the new millennium. Matt Flynn has the story.
Legendary music magazines like Billboard and Rolling Stone issued their list. The top albums differ from site to site. Albums such as Kendrick Lamar's To Pimp a Butterfly, Taylor Swift's Red, and Beyoncé's Lemonade were all in the top five. But the publications all agree that the album of the decade is Kanye West's My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy. When the album was released back in November of 2010, it was met with universal acclaim. Billboard finished the list by saying Kanye set the bar by which all 2010's albums, rap, pop, alternative, you name it, would be measured. I'm Matt Flynn.
Now we'll take a look ahead. Miles Durrett says 2020 put some new laws on the books.
One new law will allow hunters to hunt on select Sundays authorized by the Game Commission, although the law won't take effect until late February. Never before have Pennsylvania game men been able to hunt on Sundays at all. Child sexual abuse laws will also be changing. There will be greater penalties for anyone who sees child abuse and fails to report it. The law also gets rid of non-disclosure agreements that prevent victims from cooperating with police. Another new law will allow voters to mail in their ballots. Because Governor Wolf already paid for voting machines, this will not occur for Pennsylvanians in the 2020 election. Finally, any teenage smoker should be aware that the legal age to buy cigarettes and other tobacco and nicotine products has been raised from 18 to 21. I'm Miles Durrett.
Michelle Lee gives us a look into the future of new cool gadgets at the Consumer Electronics Show.
Imagine having taxis flying above your head. At the huge CES Expo in Las Vegas, Uber and Hyundai unveiled an airborne taxi to shuttle you and your luggage a distance of 60 miles. Want to go it alone? Segway introduced the S-Pod. It looks like an egg chair on two wheels. It can go up to 24 miles per hour and is designed to shuttle you around malls, airports, and theme parks. How about chilling a can of soda in 2 minutes? The Matrix Juno is a countertop cooling system that does the reverse of a microwave. Even the humble toothbrush got an upgrade. Colgate's Plaqueless Pro has a built-in sensor that scans your teeth to show how clean and plaque-free they are, and maps your mouth to show any food you missed. The one that stole the show, the Lovot. It's a Japanese-made robot that looks like an Ewok crossed with a Furby and stuck on wheels. It's designed solely to be loved. It can run around your home, talk to you with animated eyes, has a furry skin, and knows when you give it a cuddle. I'm Michelle Lee.
And here at Catholic High, we can look ahead to a bunch of exciting events. Minithon, the spring musical, a great basketball season, the prom, and graduation for the class of 2020.
Hope you enjoyed the show.
Good luck on midterms. See you next semester. You got your highbrow.